Yo, Cat Mafia. Let's get it.
Listen, there's this place in Bellevue, I was told, called Yard House.
Mm-hmm.
I have to go to it.
Yard House? That's a Jamaican spot?
It's called Yard House, bro. Like, I ate some wings. Like, I think it was some Jack Daniel wings.
Okay.
The crispy and the dipping in the sauce. Bro, like, it was fire.
Let me know when you want to go.
Dude, I'm going this Saturday. Foodie, I'm going this Saturday, bro. Like, I'm going this Saturday. Time? Yo, I don't know. I don't have a time. I'm off on Saturday. So, I'm just going to pull up.
I think, all right, bet. This is what I'm going to do. So, we had a girl that was out for, like, the last 2.5 weeks. So, I'm going to hit her up and be like, hey, bro, you want some extra shifts?
Let me know, bro. I'm going to dress up and go out, man.
Like, yo, take mine. Yeah, I'm game.
Yeah, bro. I'm gonna do something different. You feel me? But look, man, let's just get this pod started. We already started recording. Yes. But look, You already know the time. Let me get this ad lift up in here.
Yo, Cat Mafia. Let's get it.
Yeah. You already know the time. Let's get it. It's your boy Cat Mafia. Welcome to another Sesh Time podcast. I am your host, Cat Mafia, and today I have a special guest with me. Yo, Trini, you want me to call you Polly, or you just want me to just go by Trini? How do you, which one do you want to, like, be called?
Just call me Danli.
Call you Danli? Danli?
Yeah, that's... Danli.
Okay.
So, I mean, that's my name on my podcast, and that's what everybody knows me by on both the podcasts I was on. So,
all right, yeah, cool.
With Danli.
So, hold up. Just before, like, you just expand more on your podcast, Papa, because he also is a local podcaster here in Washington, just the same as me, you know, with the Sesh Time. His podcast is actually about Listen, tying up my tongue.
I got two of them. I got one called Black Poly Hot Seat, and that is, we go over a lot of different things in the ethically non-monogamous lifestyle, whether it's polyamory, which is me. We cover briefly all the E&M lifestyles, whether it's like polyandry, polygamous, polyamory, open relationships, all that. And I mean, we end up passing knowledge. We talk about things that was like current events and all that. And then with my personal one that I do, me and my partner, like, we have a session where we call Pillow Talk, where we just lay the fuck up and have a fucking blast in many different conversations. But the main thing that I'm going to be doing on that podcast is walking y'all through my journey of polyamory, whether it's like girls that I talk into or things that's happening on with me on a spiritual level as I'm digging deeper into that and the self-love journey, things that I feel that other people need to hear because they're going through the same shit. I have done a lot of things in my life that I'm proud of and things I'm not so proud of, but the way that I say it and putting those stories out there, I feel that other people can possibly learn from it. And I also want them to know that they're not alone in the shit that they're dealing with.
Yo, listen. You hear that? So look, everybody, you can follow me on the Sesh Time podcast. I will actually tag all of his podcasts up there on my page. So any information that you want to know about Danli and his two podcasts, about the Poly, I can't pronounce it, but I call it Poly. Yo, the Poly lifestyle is a crazy lifestyle for most people when they look at it, from the outlook, you know what I'm saying? Based off us being from different cultures, you know? Different cultures look at it like, what? Multiple, you with multiple partners? But again, I listened to a couple of your early show episodes, and yeah, you broke it down to a point where I understand, like, it's not what people think. You're having sex with all these ladies or all of that.
Nah.
You're getting different things from each one of them, you know? This one provides this. I could go out with this person, go to the movies. This one is athletic. I could go hiking with this. And it's different.
Facts.
Exactly. So you are able to spread out. It's just like one... In this real life, if you really think about it, one female providing all of one of man needs... It's crazy. It is the most crazy thing out here.
Because if you think about it, for one woman to provide everything that a man would want to need, that means that she has to be able to be one of the guys, while at the same time be able to switch up. Like, she has to play so many different faces. And she's going to get confused. She's not going to know exactly who the fuck she is. And I feel like that's an issue with a lot of girls these days. They constantly are trying to portray an image of what they feel that their man wants.
Mm-hmm.
But then they end up losing sight of who the fuck they are in general.
See that? See that? Listen, man. Look here. We could go all day on this topic, but you have to understand.
Yeah,
we,
but
we
got, is, yeah, that's not it right now, right? This is the reason why I started my own podcast. I'm getting into some deep shit.
I don't know exactly what to think about that.
Like,
it blows your mind sometimes, man. It blows your mind. But look here, everybody. I hope everybody is having a great week so far. As you already know, the motto for the podcast, I need you to go get your papers, get your lighters, and let us roll up our thoughts. And let us spark a conversation. You feel me? So look, yo, for the day, the topic we have, this is what the topic is going to be, okay? So this is a new thing for this season. Not for this season, but for this new year, right? I didn't tell you, Danli, this is like my 1 year anniversary for my pod. Right, 1 year I had it.
You
so
put me on for the 1 year. Yeah, I swear I feel like I'm busting a lot of fucking cherries for you tonight.
Yo, listen, bro, listen. Yeah, so this is kind of like one of my first episodes. Like I did. It actually was on the 23rd of last year when I did.
Yeah.
Right, today is the 20th, but this episode will be coming out tomorrow. You know, the 21st. So it's kind of like, yeah, man, it's 1 year in here. I feel so good. I feel happy. Yo,
CatMafia.
You know, so it's just I feel like the upgrade, you know, I could tell like where I started from to what I am doing right now. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
I'm able to like now figure out what I want this platform for. Like, it's kind of like, okay, I wanted to build up a networking platform where just like people like me and you, right? We are here locally with podcasts and stuff like that, content that we create. And it's just like, we want people in our community, right? To like, you know, so check us out, support us, give us feedback, and listen to us, as you said, like, we're, you know, we're trying to like build something for others to understand, right? Especially, especially when we come from a different, like, you know, we're dual citizens. We come from the Caribbean, you feel me? And then we come to America.
And it's so fucked up. I'm sorry, their mindset just blows my mind, bro.
Yo, it's a complete mind fuck over here, bro. It blows your mind. Like, wait a minute, where I come from, and this is what y'all do? This is how it is over here?
It's like, hold up, what? All
right, bro.
I'm like, boy, I'm about ready to smack you across your face.
Yo, look.
No.
But before I even get into the tunes for the sesh, and we get into our, and before I let y'all know what the topic is, I just want to get into some quick news. Biden, Joe Biden, yo. Listen.
Mooklandstar!
Yeah, he's on the fuck list for the night, man. I'm sorry, excuse my language, but, this dude has lost his mind, all right? So his first year, his first term is up, and this is why his polls is the worst for any president after their first year. It's crazy. His polls are the worst. He is the worst in every category you could be in the presidency. And you have to understand, that means Trump, of all people, like, everybody understand what happened to him. I haven't seen Trump since the January 6th thing last year. I don't know where he is, but look, Biden right now is looking worse than how he looked when he left office. And this is why I tell people, bro, when a white man lies, and then he lies more than once or twice, bro, the third time, bro, it's over. It's a done dada. Okay? You are trying to force the vaccine on us, okay? That you told us you would never do that. You told us we were scared that Trump then was trying to force the vaccine on us. Now we got you in power. You try to force the bill? Yo, I give a hand clap to all those senators who voted against this mandatory mandate, okay? We don't need that, all right? People have a choice. Yo, you'll call us a free country, but it don't make any sense to me. If you're trying to force a something on people when you said you would never do it. But good luck. A good thing is a Senate. And they vote. You feel me? They voted and it's gone. You feel me? Get out of here, yo. Get the
stop!
Listen. Hey, the new slang, yo, Danli, the new slang is this. Yo. Yo, let me show you a, you want me to throw you a Frank? Would you, you want me to throw you a Frank? You know what the fuck that means, bro? You know, you want to know what it means?
What is it?
You know, in New York, right? When they in New York, dudes would be like, "Yo, go suck my suck my dick." You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Now they say, "Yo, I'll throw you a Frank,"
bruh.
Because yo, it's crazy. Listen, man. Hey, there's a new slang as well called P. You feel me?
P.
Yeah, yeah. You looking P right now, man, Danli? Someone will pull up on you and say that. See, that as a West Indie, that's what I'm thinking. I'm like, bro, is he calling me a pussy? But then I hear like that is actual slang people call each other. Like they're like, if you're, I don't even know what it means. I try to listen to different podcasts and different people talk about it on Instagram. It didn't make any sense to me. Like I was not getting it. They were like, oh, if he's doing good, they call him, hey, yeah, P, what's up? P is up. Like, nah, bro. You tell that to a West Indy person, they will really think you calling him a pussy. And you might just get punched in your face. You feel me? So you might.
They don't know me. Might?
Yo! But look, man, I just want to jump off that Biden stuff, right? But y'all notice I'm wearing my Steeler. I got my Steeler hat. I don't know. Y'all ain't see it, but.
Yeah, they can't see it.
I'm wearing a Steeler hat right now. And I
black
am.
And yellow, black and yellow.
I'm at the point where I have to say, Big Ben, I appreciate you. I thank you very much for your multi of years. I swear, since the time I liked the Steelers, you were the quarterback. And that was in 2004. 2004, I became a Pittsburgh Steeler when he was drafted from the Florida College. And I was a black and yellow. You feel me? Me coming from Philly, you know, Pennsylvania, the state, Pittsburgh, was just something about those colors was stuck in my head. I knew I was a Pittsburgh Steeler fan. And I just appreciate him going into Chiefs territory. And, we got blown out. You feel me? Our offense looked like trash. It was horrible. But I just want to say to all the Seahawks fans out there, at least I was in the playoffs. So, to everybody who messaged me, except for two people who actually was concerned about my well-being and was making sure I was okay, listen, as they all say under the East Coast, I'm going to throw you a Frank.
Oh,
yo, Catman. Yo, I can't get that
for
off.
For anybody who's so goddamn slow, he said, suck my dick.
Easy. You feel me? Look, bro, Pittsburgh's still up in the bid. What's good? You feel me? So, look, enough of that. I don't think I have anything else. Yo, Danli, you have any announcement? You have anything? I know you my guest. I don't know why I would think you have announcements.
Yeah, like, what the fuck kind of announcements? What are you?
Exactly.
Like, what the fuck am I going to say?
Listen, man.
Yo, let me press the soundboard one time. I'm going to get that boop, 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 boop,
boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, boop, the reason, and I'm just going to give you like a rundown for how I came up with this, bro. You know, when you around somebody like, and you and your friend just hit a blunt or hit a bong, or y'all just sipping on a drink and y'all just chilling in the car and y'all just start having a conversation about some deep stuff. You feel me? Yeah. And I just felt like why not create a podcast where I do that with people I know, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And invite them on and we just shout it up about some stuff, right? You know what I'm saying? It's up to you of what you want to partake in. You know, that's why I tell everybody.
I find it real funny, the fact that you even invited me on here, because I'm like, so many people always tell me, they're like, yo, I thought you was an asshole until they really start talking to me.
Yeah.
they always tell me, they're like, yo, I thought you was going to be like some stuck-up asshole or something. Like, I was like, why? They're like, you always look so mad. I'm like, I'm sorry.
Man, serious. I mean, You're just a serious person. Smile. I just had to understand. Yeah. It's just like, yo, as you said, get to know you. Like, you can't judge a book by its cover. You're one of those examples. You feel me? Like, at first appearance, you're like, oh, no, bro, don't bother him, bro. He looked too serious. You know what I'm saying? He looked like he ready to take somebody out. Just chill. You feel?
I mean, that's some things. Like, I was trained that way. Like, always have a plan to kill whoever you meet. But be kind to them and be as genuine as you can.
Yo, but listen to this. This is how I want to start it off. For our topic of the day. For our keeping it blunt topic of the day. The word friend zone.
I can't fight this feeling any longer.
Ooh.
And yet I'm still afraid to let it flow. What started out as friendship has grown
Listen.
Strong.
If you have a friend out there that you have a crush on,
the strength to let it show.
But you don't have the guts, the courage.
Tell myself that I can't hold out.
For your fear, look yourself in the mirror.
I feel so secure when we're together.
I'm gonna play this until we get to the chorus. But I'm just gonna set the mood. I want you to join me on this journey.
Even as I wander, I'm keeping you in sight.
In sight.
You're a candle in the window on a cold, dark winter's night. And I'm getting closer.
Oh my gosh, this song is longer than I thought. Listen, when you can't fight those feelings anymore, this is what you gotta do. I want y'all to listen to Jada Kingdom and Deani. Not Danli, Deani.
I sing, I'll be squawking in your ears, they can believe.
Why? What you say?
I would tell you, say my love, money, press trigger. Look at baby, if my tell you, say you are my first love for sure. May I forgive it to you, cause you saved me from the streets.
Yo.
My life will be without you, can't begin.
If I ever had a lady tell me this,
don't you mean to steal me, I'm gonna look the same way. Let's get married, done with the play dates. Next 10 years, do it with the same place. Now I
say
all this type of love, no exchange. Respect you to the fullest, I'm gonna make you feel no way.
Look, so this is what the ladies tell you, right? This is how the ladies, when they confess, that's how they sound. So ladies, let me show you how fellas do it. Let me show you how the fellas do it, okay?
Listen,
this is what we do.
I don't really know what I'm doing.
Yo, I need you to prepare yourself because it's about to get a little X-rated listen. For you. But listen to it, listen to it.
You get what you want, get what you need. Love it when you tell me, baby, please. When I'm deep stroking, yeah, squeeze. Sex up on the counter, we done deep in the sheets. Focused on the bag, no, I can't give up on the streets.
Look, let me play that back one more time. Y'all ain't understand when us guys confess how we feel.
But I just thought I should tell you.
Bro, we going.
You get what you want, get what you need. Love it when you tell me, baby, please. When I'm deep stroking, yeah, squeeze. Sex up on the counter, we done did it in the sheets. Focused on the bag, no, I can't give up on the streets. Promise you stay with me and know you won't never leave. Look, baby, you my vibe. Met her in the floor, she from the state. Told me where she from, it's do or die, she by my side.
She a vibe.
She's a vibe.
Can't get you off my mind.
I've been thinking about you all day, yeah.
Can I hit it from the side? Hit it in the road, you got me switching positions. He can't do you like I do, I wanna show you what you missing. She flexible when we be having sex. I got her legs way behind her.
I'ma let this run. I need you to go get what you want to do. Get what you want to drink. Get your wine. Get your water.
Like limbo.
Get your bones. Get your blunts. Get your spliffs. Let's get it.
Get what you want. Get what you need.
Oh my God. Hold up a second. Are you eating? This guy pulled out a big plate of food on the camera and eating in front of me right now. What?
Give up on the streets. Promise you stay with me. You know you won't never leave. Look, baby, you my vibe. Met her in the floor, she from the start. Told me where she from is do or die, she by my side. I'm trying to take it up a notch. Focused on these other bitches, baby girl, you need to stop. Conversations, what I'm doing, where I'm at, you think I lie. Asking why I chose you, here's 100 reasons why. You beautiful and bold,
I had to get
mix
something.
It with some
I had
sweet.
To get
Ain't
something.
Never had these feelings, how you make me tweet. A lady outside, demon in the sheets. You do that thing I like, that's just for me. I like the way she shake it. She do that thing I like when she take it. She make it hard for me to fight temptations. If I'm on the road, she take a flight, I'm waiting. You get what you want, get what you need. Love it when you tell me, baby, please. When I'm deep stroking, yeah, squeeze. Sex up on the counter, we done did it in the sheets. Focused on the bag, no, I can't give up on the streets. Promise you stay with me, I know you won't ever leave. Look, baby, you my vibe. Met her in the floor, she from the start. Told me where she from is do or die, she by my side.
Yo! You look here.
I can spin a couple bands, don't want the headache. Can I put out my camera? Maybe we can make a sex tape.
All right. As I already said, let's get it, let's get it. I'm not going to play another song, but y'all already heard. I had to take y'all on a little journey. For I already said, to keep it blunt, word for the podcast today is friend zone. Okay? Well, these are the three questions that we're going to do. Okay? These are the three questions. Danli, you still fooling your face?
Yep.
All right, cool. So these are the three questions that we're going to do. Okay? What is friend zone? What it is, right? What is friend zone? The number two. How to realize you're in the friend zone. Number three, how to get out of the friend zone. Okay? So now, for us being guys, I feel like most likely to all the listeners out there, and again, I just want to give you all the applause as well. I went through all of that, and I just didn't say thank you to you. Just I appreciate you for wherever you're listening from. If you're listening from SoundCloud, Spotify, YouTube, Anchor Podcast, listen, man, much big ups to you. I thank you for your support, and I really appreciate it. But again, the word of the day is friend zone, and the three questions: what is friend zone? How to realize you're in it, and how to get out of it. Okay. And as I said, since we are men, we will be most likely speaking on the basis of us as men, giving you our recollections of that. So ladies, there might don't feel like we're like there's not I don't think there's gonna be much bashing, but you know, we will try our best to keep y'all side unbiased. You feel me? As much as possible. As much as possible. But since you're my guest, Natalie, I'm going to give it to you. I always let my guests go off. I'm getting better at this. You know, I kind of got some feedback that I kind of cut my guests off, but I'm getting better over time. So I'm going to allow you to jump on. So we're going to start off with it. What is friend zone, man? What is it to be in a friend zone? Like, what is it?
I mean, in all honesty, me personally, when I put someone in a friend zone, as you would call it, it's just the fact that the feelings that they may have for me, I don't have for them. So, I mean, there may be some girls who are like, oh, well, do you think you want a date? Or, hey, I've got a itch that needs to be scratched. And I'm just like, well, you better find somebody for it. Mm-hmm. Like, so, I mean, right there, that's boom. All right, cool. You're trying to get the ladder and climb the fuck out of the friend zone. Let me go ahead and help you right back down the steps, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, ultimately, I feel like a friend zone is when you don't have the same feelings that another individual has. So you let them know, not either directly or indirectly, that I'm not feeling that same way.
Okay. Yeah. So I feel that as well. Like, with that's the same. For me, when I look at the friend zone, and most of my kind, see how you said you put people in the friend zone? I am the opposite of that. So I experienced the friend zone to a point where I didn't know I was in it. So I'm not like, I'm gonna just say what it is. It's basically, you know, when you like a girl or you like a guy and you have a crush and you have feelings for this person, but low key, you're just staying a friend. You feel me? With them. And then,
you know what's even worse?
Yeah.
When they're like, I see you like a brother.
Listen, I have a story. I have a story. Listen, it's going to be a story, bro. There's going to be a damn story, bro. I have one, bro.
When the stories come,
Yo, listen. So for me, that's what I think it is. It's literally, yo, if you have a friend, yo, and you start, and you had this friend for a little while, and the people, and this is what messes it up. A lot of people think, guys, oh, look at wifey in the business. Hey, give a shout out to the SeshTime podcast.
A special guest as well. We're talking about friend zone. So I was like, you know what? Why not have a female perspective on this as well?
Okay. So, Miss Lady.
I mean, she is part of my podcast also. So
so she's your co-host? Introduce yourself, Miss Queen. Introduce yourself real quick.
What you call me?
I'm talking about Big Sucker.
Okay, we're going to stop.
Jade.
Okay. Hey y'all, my name is Jade.
Or too cute.
Alright, Jay. Too cute. Alright, so listen, we're talking about friend zone. So as a female, what is friend zone? Like, what is friend zone to you? Like, what is friend zone? Come closer to the mic. I need to hear you in the mic.
See, I said it means that he ain't got no chance of getting laid there.
Oh, dick. See how ladies say it to men? We talk about feelings. Women talk about, you ain't getting it, my brother.
You can be friends with somebody and have those feelings. Like, they can be like, once it gets past a certain point, like, you can be friends with somebody. And it'll get past a certain point where you no longer see yourself having a physical relationship.
True. And that's, that happens a lot, for real. Like, a lot of times.
You miss the opportunity. It's like this small window where it's like your relationship is cool. Excuse me. And y'all could possibly get physical. But once you pass that threshold, it's like.
It's weird.
They'll see you more as your brother or your sister. And you trust them too much. And you don't want to mess that up.
Ah,
yeah. See, and
willing to mess this one up.
See that, and that's how it is. It's kind of like some for me. Like as I said, like when it comes to the friend zone, I have experiences of being in the friend zone and not realizing it, but then was told, like literally, just told, like, bro, you my bro. I see you as a brother. Multiple times in different situations. And it's like, and I waited too long. And it became like this brotherhood type of thing. So this just transitions us right into what the next question is, right? How to realize when you're in the friend zone. For me, I didn't even realize I was in it, you know, until I was literally at the end of the cliff and I had to jump. Literally. You know what I'm saying? Like we were on this joyride. In the car. And literally, you know, it's in the Sahara Desert. And you just driving like, okay, yeah, we good. But then it's at the end of the road, it's a damn cliff. Instead of me just telling the female how I feel, I wait till we reach to the end of the cliff. I jump off. She don't jump off with me. So that's how I felt when the female told me straight to my face in Red Robin, yo, Javi, just letting you know. And I don't remember what I told her to get her to tell me this.
Yeah.
But she said, yo, I just got to let you know, man. I like you as a brother, bro. Like, and she put the bruh at the shit, too. So it sound more homie, like homie. I'm right
so
there.
Like, no question. It's just like, ding.
And guess what? It was a classic date. It was like Red Robin, you know, in Auburn, Red Robin in the theater right there to get in that, whatever, that plaza. Out. So I did all of that. You know, she ordered the veggie burger with the lettuce and the burger shit. I remember the whole date. Messed up my life, bro. I was 20, bro. I was like, yeah, 20. 2014 is when it happened. My life changed as a young Caribbean dude here in America. And I took this girl out on a date and she tells me straight to my face. And we were friends before that. Like, we worked together and stuff. And like, I just asked her out on a date. She says, like, yo, I like you as a brother. Like, nothing more. I don't.
Okay. And this but is here's after a question. She... Like, hold up. As a woman, though, I got a question, though.
Uh-huh.
So, would you have rather her have told you on that date Or would you rather her string you along?
Oh, no, no, no. That's why it helped me. It helped me realize what that's the... What yeah, saying, it helped me.
Some people, they be like, I really didn't want to know. You ain't had to hurt my feelings like that. We could have just kept it the way it was, and it would have been fine.
And you have to understand, like, right now, how could I put it? My rejection shell is very... I have a turtle right now. Like, I have a turtle shell. So if I get rejected, I have a shell I could go into. I didn't have a shell at that point. So I, like, yo, I was fragile. When she told me that, I was literally sitting at the table, yo. And you have to understand, I couldn't even, I'm very emotional. I'm a Cancer, so I'm emotional. So I let a lot of shit build up. So throughout the date, I'm getting angry and more angry to the point, why the fuck am I paying for everything right now? And this girl seems up, bro. So I'm forgetting that we're friends. My brain ain't even on as friends no more because I'm ready to I like you. I want you. But you over here like, nah, you know. But to this day, the good thing is I'm still friends with her, right, to this day. Like, we're still cool. But it was to the point, like, after her, everything just went down the drain, man. But give me, Danli, give me, and then also, Jay, you could give a story, like, if any situation y'all ever had, like, how did y'all realize, like, y'all were in the friend zone at that point? Like, how did you, like, any situation?
I'm going to hit the most recent one. The one that keeps running back to the fucked up individuals. This was happened actually last year. And I was talking to this girl. We was vibing. We was kicking it off. She would come over from time to time. And we would, like, watch some anime, sip a couple drinks. We would smoke some as well. And, I mean, everything's going good. She's, like, she already knows about Jade and everything. They have met a couple times. Mm-hmm. And she seemed like she was cool about it and everything. And we've never gotten, like, physical or anything. We've kissed a couple times. And going later on down the road, like, she, you see that face she making?
Yo, you have to say, I am looking at her, by the way.
She's always looking out for my best interest. Like, yeah. She's talking a lot. She's always looking out for my best interest. And with it, it was like, one day she just goes off and she's like, She's like, no, well, I don't know how I feel about the poly thing, which I was like, okay, you're triamorous, whatever. Mm-hmm. She's like, if I'm with a guy, then I would want him to always be there. I was like, all right, cool. Well, he's there, but whatever. I've proven it to you that I'd be there if you need me. So whatever. And then later on down the road, she's like, calls me a couple times and she's crying, talking about like, oh,
men ain't shit.
Yeah.
Really?
Men ain't shit. And she keeps running back to, like, guys who keep fucking Rover, and she had something good that was there, but she overlooked it.
Yeah.
And I was just like, I was like, who was that? Just to be petty, you know?
Yeah.
And she was like, you haven't done anything wrong, and da-da-da, whoop-de-woo. And I'm just like, oh. And honestly, in my mind, the other side of me was just like, suck it the fuck up. You knew what the fuck you had, like, so fucking be it. Like, keep it moving. Mm-hmm. You want to run back to dumb motherfuckers, then do that shit. And if you're going to come cry to me, you better find somebody else to cry to, because I'm not, you are, thank you for not wasting my time. But of course, the little gentleman side of me was just like,
Mr. Nice Guy, Mr. Nice Guy, huh?
Yeah. I was like, let me listen to
my
him.
Ass over here is like, fuck it.
Look at that. You know what I'm saying? Ride and die right there. You know?
So I'm sitting on the phone, I'm listening to her and everything, and then she's apologizing to me and everything. And she's like, why does it seem like you don't care? I was like, it's not so much I don't care, but see, on my journey of everything that I've gone through, of the years of women taking advantage or either just putting me in the friend zone, not recognizing my worth, when I had to learn what my worth is myself, you know? Mm-hmm. I've learned that I have a lot of love to give. And with that, there's categories to this shit. Cause I for the longest time, I've been draining myself, just throwing love out to everybody. And I'm just like, they don't return it back. So with that, I'm like, you know what? I'm not going to do, my mom has a saying that she told me. She was like, don't want anything for somebody more than they want it for themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So that's with a good that, saying for real. I broke people down into categories. And I was like, you know what? This is the amount of time you show me. That's the amount of time I'm going to show you. I was like, okay, cool. This is the things that you will do for me and what you won't do for me. Then I will do the same for you.
So therefore, people that are higher up and actually show me that they give a fuck, I give them all that I can, as much as they would give me, and so on and so forth, based on the other categories.
Yeah.
So with that, therefore, I'm not wasting my energy recharging motherfuckers who are not giving anything back to me, but yet once they fully charge, they walk the fuck away and have a happy life or get drained by some other people that they know they shouldn't be with.
Mm.
So when it comes down to the friend zone, I'm like, I will give you as much as you give me. And if you give me enough to where I feel like you reach a level of caliber to where you don't, you shouldn't be in the friend zone because of the connection and everything that we can do for one another to where we are literally operating as a partner, then I know you're not in that friend zone. Other than that, I'm gonna make it known that you're in the friend zone.
Straight up. I mean,
you sitting there like, oh, I'm cold. I'm like, well, shit, there's a Ross down the road. You can go buy a jacket. Like, oh, I can't wear yours? Nah, you can't, because I'm going to be cold, and I don't give a fuck about you that much, you know? So, I mean, that's just where I'm at in life.
Listen,
in all
listen. And it's really honest, and it's, that's really honest.
Fuck that shit. No, no. Did I pay for that blanket? Yes, I did. You better figure the fuck out.
See that? Like, and, like, there's a saying that people are trying to, like, try to defend a lot. Like, the nice guys finish last, right? Which... Mm-hmm. I'll be honest, man. Nice guys lie. Because we as men are very blunt. Yo, some things we really don't want to do. Like, there's a lot of times we are friends with women and we don't want to do what things, like, be available when they want you. Because they always call you, oh, hey, what you doing right now? Can you do me a favor? Because you have a crush on you, like this
laptop,
person.
Closest Pornhub. Oh, no, I'm free. What you need?
That's it. I'm there. You feel me?
That makes me think. He said nice guys finish last. It's like, no, nice guys get what they deserve, just not in the timeline that they thought it was.
See, in my mind, I was like, nice guys do finish last because you're going to think of her before you. So you make sure she come before you do. But
and
anyway,
that, and for me, that is what, over time for me, I had I had one of my homies. Like, he kind of like
completely went over his head.
He kind of like broke it down to me. Broke it down to me to a point because I was considered a nice guy a lot because I had a lot of females I had as friends, right? And a lot of times he looked at it to a point like, bro, are you having threesomes in your crib with these girls? Like, you have these girls by your house all the time. Like, they're just there. And I'm just like, yeah, that's cool. Like, they're my friends. You feel me? He's like, yo, Javi, I know you, bro. Like, I know you, man. Like, you don't, you ain't over here just not trying to smash. But it's just like, you just over here just entertaining them, buying bottles, showing off that you got money and all these type of things. And it's like, they use you for something at a certain point. You know what I'm saying? And then what? They tell you about the niggas that they're fucking. They tell you about their stories and shit. But you are the what? You become their fucking sticky wall. They put all their garbage, all their fucking nonsense on you. And while they go scot-free, you have to worry about their business and their shit.
So, yo, peep game real quick. You remember when my brother was down here?
Who?
P?
Oh, yeah, Prince.
Yeah. Yeah. So with that, I had this same conversation with before. I was like, bro, you realize that this house has been known now as the party house. For example, like that one time you randomly popped up and almost got shot when me and him was all like over there watching a movie, having family nights, and you popped up and was like, yo, so what's going down? And you were like, yo, what the fuck you doing here? And you were like, yo, this is the after hours
spot,
right?
Spot.
We like, yo, nigga, go home. What the fuck? Like,
yeah, it was a crazy night.
Down, put the guns down.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I mean, I had to tell him, I was like, look, you always doing all this shit. I was like, we spending money buying food, bottles, and all this. People come over here. I was like, they drink, they eat. Nobody contributes to anyway.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, so really, I was like, bless, babe.
I'm out. I gotta go deal with the babies.
All right, Jay.
So I was like, yo, in all honesty, I was like, these people are pretty much just using you. I was like, they're using you for the things that you have. I was like, if anything, we should start charging, because if we start charging, I guarantee you more than half these mother cunts ain't even going to come.
Mm-hmm.
He was like, well, nah. He was like, nah, I'm setting up my own.
What? Yeah, whatever. Okay. It is. Yeah. You know, you're
spinning that. His web, you know?
Yeah.
Spinning the web. It's like, okay, whatever. But then with it, it's like, you're wasting all this time, energy, and money for people who are not even a guarantee, which that right there is going to take me down a little rabbit hole real quick.
Yeah.
As a man, we are pretty much supposed to be the providers. With that, the women expect us to do everything. We have to talk. We have to go and approach them, talk to them, win over their favor and likeness. Then at the same time, pick out, plan a date, pick them up, be chivalrous, pay for it. Then at the end, it's like we go our separate ways. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, in this day and age, the way that girls are, notice I say girls, not women. Way that girls are is they won't even really give a fuck if they like you or not, but they'll accept a date just because of the fact they'll get free shit.
And the expectation of what a man should do on that date, right?
Exactly. So, I mean, now it's like, when I go out on dates and everything, some girls be getting mad at me because I'm like, yo, we covering our own food. Because I'm not going to sit here and be a motherfucker constantly. I'm not going to be an enabler to where you, example, I knew this one girl. She told me that every night she's literally plans her dates to where she has a date every night. So that way she gets free dinner every night. And I was like, what the fuck? Whether she likes the person or not, she goes out on a date because she's getting free shit.
See that?
And I was like, see, you're the type of, honestly, because of her is the reason I am that I am now. Because you remember me back in the day. I could be what the world these days call a simp.
True. Had them all.
So, I mean, like, I wouldn't say that I was a simp, but I've always been a loving individual. I have so much love to give.
That's what I'm meaning. Like, some people take it to a different, the simp thing is a term opposite of alpha, right?
A simp stands for sucker in love with mediocre pussy or penis. So, I mean, that's literally what S-I-M-P is.
Really?
So, I mean, yes, dead ass. That's a term from back in the day. So when the people were saying simp, I was like, what the fuck? They bringing that shit back?
Damn.
Like, I'm an old soul, bro. I know the shit.
I heard
simp stands for sucker in love with mediocre pussy or penis gender.
Yeah, for me, simp was always used as though, usually not to nice guys, but to the opposite of what, as I would say, to the opposite of, as I said, alphas. Like, you were simp, bro. You just chasing after the wrong. You chasing after something that you know you can't get. But, yeah, you broke it down to the point. And my last podcast, I touched on purpose. That was the word, the keep it blunt word for that podcast. Purpose, right? And a lot of times, I know we're talking about the friend zone. As a man, you have to figure out what your purpose is. And once you know what your purpose is, you would notice that you're in the friend zone. Like, certain things that you, as you said, when you said nice guys finish last, I didn't even realize, like, to the point, like, how you describe it. Like, they really do. We do really finish last. Like, you know, because I can still say I'm a nice guy, but I became more blunt with my responses now. Right? It's more honest now. Like, if I don't want you, bro, if you start talking about, oh my God, I went out to the club. Like, I have one of my friends right now, one of my best friends. She calls me every time. We have conversations. But the minute she starts talking and gossiping about some stuff I don't want to hear, she knows. I tell her, I'd be like, nah, bro, I don't want to hear none of this. You know, it's all Gucci, bro. You know, and so over time, you know, and this was last year I told her about it. This year, like, as time went on, the phone calls became less, right? Because she has nothing to call me for. But the point is, she's a friend. Like, I have her in, like, I would say I have her in the friend zone, or we're just friends, you know? But it was I don't have a crush on her in anything. But I see how with me just being her friend as a guy and willing to be a friend, she thinks she could just come and talk to me about other men. So visualize if you are a man and you have a friend and you just have a crush on a female, right? And that's the only reason why you're friends with her. And she's over here talking about all the dudes she's being out with. Oh my God, this dude broke my phone. Oh my, telling you about all the shit that the dudes are doing to her, all the guys are doing wrong to her, while you thinking like, bro, I'm the guy for you. Right behind, this is what you're saying to yourself in the mirror. Just like how the song say, can't fight this feeling. You feel me? You're in the mirror just trying to, yeah, bro, one day she's going to pick me. She's going to realize it's me. Nah, bro, it doesn't work like that.
You know, the worst ones, though, is like when you are the perfect guy for the girl. And she's complaining to you about all the things that guys are doing. But then she starts saying, like, I give up on guys. There's no guy out there that can treat me right. And it's like, yo, maybe if you just go ahead and stop bumping your fucking gums, close your mouth and open your eyes and pay attention to what's in front of you. Because I am that. I it's like, yo, that man that you are talking to and complaining about all these things about possibly could be that mirror. He is seeing you for who you are. and he is willing to love you wholeheartedly. But yet, y'all are so stuck up on wanting to fall into this social status, these trends and type shit, to where it's like, oh, well, I need a nigga like this, or I need a nigga with six figures and a big dick and blah, 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 and all this other shit. And it's like, yo, but you understand that everything you're looking for is really ultimately opposite of who you are. That's why I feel like that's why so many women get into these toxic ass relationships back to back to back without taking the time to heal, and then keep getting upset talking about niggas ain't shit. Every guy I've been with does the same shit. Well, maybe if you break that fucking level of insanity, doing the same thing over and over and over again, hoping for a different result, then maybe you'll understand that there's plenty of guys around you that surround you who are perfect for you, but trying to find something that you know is not good for you, but the fact that everybody else, all the other girls out there are going to see you with this person and they're going to feel some type of way. So now you feel like you're elevated to a higher level.
Yeah.
Get off that status shit.
See that?
Find somebody who's actually good for you, not somebody who looks good for you, you know?
And the same thing I would say about most fellas as well. Like, most of the time, bro, there's be females out there, bro. And us as guys, we don't realize, like the one that you want is right here. Like, she's right there looking at you. But you out here a fuckboy. You know that term? Fuckboy, you
nah,
out.
Nah, nah. Hey, can I correct you real quick?
Go ahead.
Not the one that you want, but the one that you need is right there.
Oh, I like, okay.
You out there trying to find ones that you want.
I like that. Thank you for that correction. I like that term. Okay. See that? I need to look in the mirror. I need to find the woman I need. Not the want. Yes. You hear that, Seshes?
Yes.
Not the wants is your flesh. You feel me? The need is your heart. What does your heart need? I love. Oh my gosh, we taking that. We're taking that quote to the. Oh!
You see that? I get on some deep shit. That's why I tell you I had to break off and do my own thing. Because I mean, like, I go there.
Yo, listen, man. But I think we just ran into like how to get out of it. See how we transitioned right into the third question. It is simple, bro. Just be honest, fellas. Be honest, females. If you like this guy, I understand the game. You know, he wants to buy it for me, so he wants to buy me dinner. Why not? You know, he wants to go take me out shopping. Why not? But understand, you're hurting him mentally. When you hear like I know some guys, I have friends, man, like people, even me. I suffer from mental.
A lot of fucking friends. Mental, bro. I can't keep up with the mother cunts, bro.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, we have too many. But it's just to the point where, for my mental health, right? I suffer from depression, like from my childhood to now. People will look at me when I'm out as the happiest person, but y'all don't know when I'm in my house, in my room, in my dark room, sitting down, what I'm thinking, what's going through my head.
Pills I take, y'all.
Yo,
like,
y'all don't really know. You know what I'm saying? It's like, for me, I don't like talking so much on it because, again, it's a battle that I have to fight. You know, and as you said, if I could find a female who I could allow to come into this battle with me, can you handle what I could open up and tell you? Can you handle the darkness? Can you be that little bit of flashlight to help me? Because I have a little bit of light. I need, when they tell you gasoline, I need more gasoline on my fire. And I need to find a woman, a female, that could provide that. I have a lot of female friends. Each one of them helped me out with conversations, things of that nature, and we were good friends. But I have no crushes on any of them. Anybody that I had crushes on or had a sexual, I just either cut them off or to the point, like, I just, like, stop being what they concern. Nice guy, you feel me? Being available whenever they wanted me there. Having those conversations about their ex-boyfriend, about their boyfriend. Things of that nature.
Boss.
You know?
Hey, so with that, that might have been a big part of the depression. Because granted, I'm still on meds, antidepressants and shit, my damn self.
Yeah.
Whatever. But when you're always that person to where everybody can talk to, who the fuck can you talk to? And that right there builds up a lot on you as well. So therefore, it's like you are constantly helping everybody else, draining your battery, but then you have no one to talk to help you recharge your own. So I feel like that right there is the biggest part of why we go into depression, because in America, the way that we are in the Caribbean and the islands, we are genuinely kind individuals. We say what we mean and mean what we say.
Exactly.
We will look out for one another. Mm-hmm. In America, they don't give a fuck. They're all literally selfish as fuck, majority of the time looking out for themselves. And I've learned that out here in Seattle.
Yeah, it's a doggy dog world. Like, kind of like, and that's, and I get that sentiment. Like, it is that way. And that's why I wanted to create this platform where people mm-hmm. like us in the scene, like with the Caribbean, the Africans, and African Americans, like, yo, yeah. we all are here living in America. We all are the same color, which y'all say colorism, right? Y'all care about the color of people's skin. For me, where we come from, bro, once you a Bahamian, bro, you Bahamian, bro. Anybody opposite of that, what they say, throw you a fright. Throw you a fright. Throw you a fright. You feel me? Exactly.
Come again, we like an army. Anyway, sorry,
listen, no. Look at you. Look at you with this right here. I mean, like
Marshall said it the best. He said, we don't see red. We don't see color. We see strength. We see power. Like, and that's just how we are back where we from.
Man,
and
I mean, look here, you got me wanting to play that song, man.
It's ridiculous.
You got me wanting to play that song, man. But look,
I mean, like, true talk, no lie. I mean, shoot, the coat of arms in Trinidad and Tobago is together we aspire, together we achieve. Like, I mean, you literally have to come together as one. Granted, in Trinidad right now, the fucking Indians and Afros are split the fuck apart. But hey.
Man, I heard that story from my friend, and she's Guyanese, mm-hmm. and she told me about how she can't marry somebody, and like, it's something about, because she's not full Indian, something she's not full of, like, yeah. like, you can't marry anybody you want in Guyana. They, like, you have to be full, you have to be, like, full something. She explained it on my Roatan episode,
mm-hmm.
and it was pretty interesting to me because it was the first time I've ever heard of a person from the Caribbean who actually, like, as I said, she's a beautiful woman. So it's kind of for her to say, like, yo, she felt racism in her own country to the point where she could even marry anybody from her being Guyanese. They didn't look at her as full Guyanese because she was something else. She was mixed with something else. And it was just like... Yeah, like, I just felt I can't represent. Like, she still represents her home to the fullest, right? She still goes back home. But she just expressed that sentiment of, like, not every Caribbean islands is the same based off the cultures. And you just, as you just touched on, like, everybody is not the same. And the same thing I realized about Africa, too. You know, like, us in the Caribbean, me in the Bahamas especially, I didn't know Africa was such a separated country to the point not united in any type of form or form. Like, I really thought they were like America. I didn't know they were not like America in a way. Yeah, it was weird.
When I learned that, I was like, yo, what the fuck? I learned that after I learned that Nigeria is not pronounced Nigeria. I mean, I'm sorry. My aunt raised me to, like, always pronounce these words. So therefore, with Nigeria, when you look at it, it's ni,
yeah, it is. So, it is, yeah. yeah. I never heard that before. Nigeria. Sorry, listen, I apologize to any Nigerians listening right now. We is just something with West Indies we go through. It's just like how whenever anybody say, yo, if we tell anybody we from the Caribbean, where do they always think we're from? Who are they?
Jamaica.
Thank you.
Fucking Jamaica. Oh,
rude.
Yeah, man,
exactly, man. Just like that's how we feel most of the time. Like, y'all always think we come from one place, Jamaica. Like, oh, you from the Caribbean? You from Jamaica? Oh my God, I want to go to Jamaica so bad. You don't even wait for us to say where we from. You just go straight to, oh, I want to go. I was there on a cruise. I'm like, man, y'all are funny. But look, bro, I have the song playing in the background, by the way. We're taking a music break. We be talking too much. Man, look here. Y'all need to go listen to that song, man. Family. It's a good song. Famale. Like we play we play that song in the when we play that at Champions, man. It's look, it goes wild. It goes crazy.
I lose my fucking mind. Anytime if y'all ever come to Champions and some soca comes on and y'all see a mother cunt just running around with a Trinity flag waving, that's most
That's Danli. You feel me? But look, yo, Danli, yo, we we coming to the end of the pod. It's almost we have 5 more minutes left. I just wanted to say, like, let's just give our give your last thought. I want you to give your last thoughts on the word friend zone. Any last thing you want to say to the Seshers about the word friend zone?
Well, shit.
Any advice you would give?
Let me think on this. For anybody who really does enjoy the time accompany of the individual who they see as a friend, do not stop anything that could be coming your way by the fact of you thinking that the person's not right for you. I mean, through trial and error, like for me, I fight Muay Thai and with it. If I lose a match or whatever, I lose a fight. My coach doesn't say, hey, you lost, is what did you learn? Everyone who enters your life is a lesson or a blessing. I mean, you give that individual who's been there for you for years or longer than anybody else in your life a chance, you might just actually find happiness rather than complaining to an individual about how you constantly keep being used. Now, this is for men and women, because, I mean, we all go through the same thing. And the fact that we speak different languages, we're not able to communicate to one another that we are hurt, that we're seeking to be healed. But also at the same time, so we can stop this whole insanity that's going on right now, I say, after a relationship, take the time to learn to love yourself. Because once you find love in yourself, you're not going to be seeking it from another individual. So therefore, when you do get into a relationship, they're adding on to the love that you already have, rather than you trying to teach them how to love you.
Repeat that one last time, that last part.
They're adding on to the love that you have rather than you trying to teach them how to love you.
Bars. You feel me? You have to realize, man, if you want somebody to love you.
Bruh, I see it in your face. Don't get all sentimental on me.
Yo, you making me emotional, bro. I only have 4 more minutes. I can't go into my yo, I was heartbroken, bro. In the airport, my days at SeaTac Airport. My earlier days, before I was in the scene, bro, before I was in the reggae scene and the dancehall scene, I was like it was bad for me, bro. I had a learning curve that was crazy for me. But since you brought that song up, I'm gonna end the podcast with Famale. You feel me? We're gonna jam out with this. But I just wanna say again, when it comes to the SeshTime podcast, we give you advice, we give you information, we give you what? We give you a networking basically, look. You use the word web. I'm trying to make or create a web. You know, where you could come at, and if you need information on anything, you could come and listen in. You feel me? And I just appreciate all the listeners who listen in all the time, who check in and give me advice, give me feedback on the podcast, if they liked it or if they didn't like it. I really do appreciate it. But before we get to the end of it, I jammed this song out. Shout out to your podcast one more time. Let the people know where they can follow you at.
The name of my podcast is Danli's Polyam Adventures. So Danli apostrophe S, Polyam, Polyam Adventures. If you don't know how to spell adventures, you probably shouldn't be trying to find my podcast.
Amen.
And the second one is Black Poly Hot Seat. Now, that one is discontinued, but all our episodes are still up there. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you have any questions or you're curious about any ethically non-monogamous, a.k.a. E&M lifestyle, or you feel that you may be, come listen to that one. That one is pure informational.
See that, yo. Look, man. And I just want to give a hand clap to Danli, yo. I appreciate you for coming on to the podcast. And again, thank you. And yo, to all my sessions out here, I'm your host, Cat Mafia, Linky!
Let me tell you one time, family is family and not different from
chorus run. We gonna let that chorus run. You ready?